Hello YouTube, this is Tiki Bomber here again. I know, videos, huzzah. Maybe I could do more than just maybe like one a month, possibly. Anyways, what I'm getting into today, on today's topic in general. First of all, there was a 17-year-old Swedish girl who had defended herself against her rapists and is now facing charges in the courts. I could see due process needing to be done and all that other stuff. However, I wish I could get more on this story as Sweden is now becoming the rape culture capital of the whole world. It just seems like all of a sudden, when they open the floodgates for these refugees to go filing through, and didn't question who was a refugee and who was not a refugee, but everybody's filing through under the refugee status, that Sweden has become a rape capital country, which says a lot about that whole scenario in general. I don't know if all the refugees that are being are rapists or not in Sweden. I do know that not all refugees are rapists, but those committing the crimes, who knows if they're actual rapists or if they're actual refugees, well, they're really rapists. If they're really refugees or if they are under the guise of a refugee to make the refugees look bad, or they're ISIS members and they can't keep their fucking dicks in their damn pants. Yeah. So the topic itself got me worked up because one, she's being faced charges for defending herself. A 17-year-old was defending herself. I give her huge props, good on you. Do that. Protect yourself. Because that is all you have to rely on is yourself. Feminists who sit there and bitch and complain and moan and groan and whine and gripe and all that other shit, who relies on the government to protect them, and then gets pissy when the government refuses to protect them. You can learn a lot from this 17-year-old girl who protected herself. So, am I mad that she's facing charges? Yes, I'm actually very mad that she's facing charges, that she's being treated as a criminal when she was the victim. Is due process going to be expected? Yes, and I really hope the Swedish, I really hope the Swedish jurisdiction policies about self-defense in an aggressive attack, much as how it's registered here in America, yes, rape, attempted rape can be seen as an aggressive attack, by the way, in America. Self-defense, and when it comes to defending yourself in an aggressive attack, can have one of two things happen. One, you would be charged for any damage done to your rapist or your would-be rapist. Two, your would-be rapist would walk away scot-free to either attempt to rape you another day or rape somebody else instead. Three, the charge gets dropped and the would-be rapist would instead face charges in the criminal judicial system. I'm really hoping the third option happens with this because it would look incredibly horrible to Sweden to let a would-be rapist walk away scot-free and punish his would-be victim from being raped. The very thing that feminists try to sit there and stop, and yet nobody else outside of myself has spoken up about this 17-year-old girl that I've seen so far. Oh. So, the big portion's out of the way. That's fine. Good. 5 minutes in. I guess that would be the smaller one. You know, that's the good thing. She fought off a rapist. Good on her. Keep up the hard work. Keep doing that. Continue to defend yourself. It don't matter if you're a chick or if you're a dude. Defend yourself against would-be rapists. And it doesn't even matter if your rapist is a chick or a dude. The moment they lay their hands on you and you are uncomfortable with it and you've already told them to stop, is seen as sexual harassment. The moment they start stripping you to penetrate you or to be penetrated by you is seen as rape or would be rape. As soon as penetration happens, either you either you're being penetrated or you're being forced to penetrate, then it's rape. But only if you did not want it. And you made your intentions very clear from the get-go, you do not want it. All right. Moving on to the bigger, better, badder dogs of the whole scenario with Sharia law. Apparently, Britain political parties believe that Britain itself would become a better place under Sharia law. I would disagree. For starters, Sharia law itself is part of the Islam religion. It is followed in Islamic states, even if you yourself are not in Islam. And for some odd reason, we're not allowed to follow our own rules and regulations when it comes to laws. But when it comes to Sharia law, it's perfectly okay to follow them because, hey, it's a feminist thing. Hey, it's a better thing. Hey, it's a great thing. So let's look at some great points about Sharia law. I'm going to start off with my very favorite one, the top of the line. First and foremost, under Sharia law, if you steal and get caught for it, the price isn't a slap on the wrist. Nah. You lose your dominant hand. So. And they don't just sit there and say, oh yeah, we'll just run it over with a car or anything. No. They fucking cut off your hand. Age does not limit them what is deemed to be theft or an accident. Remember, there was a 7-year-old boy who had his right hand and arm ran over because he stole from a store. And this is under Sharia law. Actually, if I remember right, that news article happened, I want to say 2012 to 2013. It was like very early on in the 2010s. At least when I saw it. That was something very horrible for me to read and think about. However, at the time, my thoughts was, that's in their country. They can keep their barbaric methods to themselves. And I'm very much so agreeable to that to this day. You can keep your barbaric methods to yourselves in your own country. You want to make the world a better place? Start by changing out the way that you guys run things, first and foremost. Let's look further on into Sharia law and how it's a much better solution to running a country than the laws already placed in here. All right. So let's go back to that 17-year-old girl who fought off a rapist. Even if she was to be raped, by the guy, she would have faced one of two penalties. The first one is that she would have been buried up to her neck in sand and then stoned to death because she was raped. The second penalty would have been, instead of facing the stoning, she would have had to marry her rapist instead. Honestly, that sounds like the Neanderthals and the cavemen, where if they find a woman they want, they knock them out and then they rape them and they kept them. It is a very backwards way to see the world. I understand that there were feminists who was strongly against that particular law, to the point that it was popping up everywhere as being seeing a wrong thing. And it still is a wrong thing. However, I don't see the feminists complaining about how rape victims would have to marry their rapists in the Middle East. I don't see women complaining about how rape victims would be stoned to death in the Middle East. Instead, I am right now seeing feminists trying to support and encourage and pass Sharia law in countries where these practices are seen as very backwards, very barbaric, and very inhumane. You're the same bitches who were complaining about rape victims having to marry their rapists and turn around within a year's time to promote that rape victims should marry their rapists. You're not feminists if you think one way and then become a hypocrite on that. You're just a disgusting piece of trash who's trying to attach themselves to something to get their voices heard and to get a movement to change direction. As for the hijab, I don't give a flying rat's ass if you wear one or not. That's part of your religion? Okay, I can respect that. It is a belief that you have. That's fine. Wear a hijab if it's part of your religion. Cover your hair if it's part of your religion. But do you know what's part of my religion? Do you know what it is about being a pagan that makes it so blasphemous to other religions? Heavily more so to people of Islam? Pagans. More focused on the Celtic pagans and the Norse pagans, did not wear a lot of clothing. We do not cover our heads unless it's for battle. And we fight to the very fucking end to make sure that our ways are still liberated in what we believe in. It is why America is a great country. We allow you to follow your religious practice. And we allow you to do so as long as nobody else gets hurt in the process. As long as nothing else gets hurt in the process. It is why pagans in America are not allowed to perform animal sacrifices or human sacrifices. Voodoo witch doctors are not allowed to perform human sacrifices or animal sacrifices. It don't matter what your religion says about what your punishments should be and dishing them out. What does matter is that you still practice your religious faith, and you do so without judging others. If I get stoned to death tomorrow because I refuse to wear a hijab, there's a good fucking chance that I would take down several people before I will ever be convicted of heresy. England has that had that same belief system, where they didn't really care what religion you practiced as long as nobody got hurt. Now, all England wants to do, what they really want to do, is enforce Sharia law. Because getting your hands cut off for theft, on a first-time offense no less, is a much beneficial way to run a government, to run an entire society, than imprisonment. And I will say, yeah, there are some benefits to that. For starters, you don't have to actually feed any prisoners for stealing. You don't have to house them and expect the taxpayers to take care of that. Oh, no. That's already done for. Just cut off the hand. They learned their lesson. Because Sharia law is so great that it now promoting what feminists originally fought against, which is that if a woman is raped, she would either be stoned to death or would have to marry her rapist. Because punishing the victim is always a great way to run a nation. Because speaking ill of Muhammad or Allah and you're non-Muslim means that you are open for punishment and being stoned to death. That is a great way to support your country who has other religions and atheists who do not believe in a higher being. Because if you're gay, either a lesbian or a homosexual, you are expected to have one of two things done to yourself. By the way, huge thank you on making this a great law to have in the Western worlds. As a gay person, you would either be forced to go through a transition sex change operation, which Justin is like, well, yeah, this is a great thing. But let's face it, Justin's really a straight guy pretending to be a lesbian. So he wouldn't have to go through anything. He doesn't see the issue with this. I see an issue with this for the people who are gay. The real gays. The real lesbians. You are forced to have your gender changed. Because you like to sleep with guys as a guy. You're forced to have your gender changed. Because you like to sleep with other girls as a girl. And if that's not enough for you, if you really deny, absolutely fight against getting your gender changed, then you're either thrown off a building and die or stoned to death. Yes, Sharia law is a great practice for the Western world who already have the promotion of the LGBT community involved, who just recently allowed for gay marriages to be passed within the Western world, not even a decade later. And now you're sitting there saying, yeah, we should go ahead and throw all these gays off buildings. Yeah, we should have them stoned to death because they want to be gay. Yes, let's force gender operation changes on these gays because that's part of Sharia law, the most positive movement in the world. If you consider yourself part of the LGBT community, or a supporter for the LGBT community, and you support Sharia law in the process, you're fucked up. You're just as fucked up as the feminists who are against rape culture, but support Sharia law. You're just as much as a fucking hypocrite. And all of it is very, very, very disgusting shit. I'm Tiki Bomber. I'm also known as Keely Ann Craig. I am against Sharia law in the Western world. This is part of my protest. Until next time, peace.